Hi guys, it's DJ here from CozyRC. Welcome to part 7 of my GeForce Twin Mono. In this episode I will install the drive system, the motors, motor mount and also the liners of the flex shafts. Install the LiPo tray, work on the bottom of the hull, including these interesting spray rails. So stay tuned and let's go. When we look at the bottom side of the boat, I didn't show this very often yet, but I finally spent some time to make it how I wanted it. First off, it's very important that the bottom of your V-hull is as straight as you can get it. So when I put a ruler here, there is basically no gap between the ruler and the surface of the boat. And the same for the other side. You don't want to have a hollow shape or a bowl shape, because it will increase drag and your boat will not be as fast. I really spent a lot of time using different sand blocks, sanding the bottom of the hull, until it was really straight. Another interesting thing that I added to this hull, these sides from 25 centimeters measured from the transom, the side of this hull starts to go up. Or actually, it will start to go down, but in this position it goes up. And finally it ends with a 6 mm rise measured from the dead rise. I filled the gap between the side and the bottom with thickened epoxy, again thickened with carbon strands. I still need to touch up some low spots, and the same for the other side. What I hope to achieve with this is that the water will exit the hull from the back of the boat and not from the side. I hope that it will reduce drag, and maybe it will also improve the cornering, because when the boat leans into the corners, I think it works like a small turn fin. This part will bite into the water, or at least I hope. Let's see. If it doesn't work at all, or when it will give the boat some funny behavior, I will just send them off. I will put a laminate, 110 grams of glass fiber in this case. I think this bottom is already very strong. It's made from 1.5 mm ply, and as you have seen from the inside, it's already laminated with carbon fiber. So I think one piece of glass weave will give the required strength, and then basically the entire boat is waterproof. Alright, so the motor setup is basically done. I glued the motor bracket in place. I used thickened epoxy and I thickened it with cotton flocks. That gives a really strong bond. And I also added some carbon powder to make it black. Altogether, it became really strong, so I'm really happy with how it turned out. I glued these wooden side ribs, so I also glued the bottom of this carbon bracket with the bottom of the hull. And I also bended the brass liners for the flex shafts. They only have a very small bend, so I think the flex shaft will run with very low resistance. The alignment of the flex shaft is pretty good. When I slide the flex shaft out of the coupler and I slide it back, it goes into the coupler without hitting it. Very smooth. For the other ones the same. So I'm really happy with that. I also added a support for the brass liner to prevent any vibration in the flex shaft. When you look from the top, you see that these supports don't align. This one is a little bit closer, this one is a little bit further away from the motor. But actually I don't care. The reason why I did it is that in this position the supports touched the hull bottom and also touched the liner nicely. And for this support the position was here. And to reach the same result for this support the position was here. So yeah, they are like a little bit angled when you compare them with each other, but what matters to me is that the alignment with the flex shaft and the coupler is very accurate, which it is. I also glued in place the lipo tray. In the previous video I've shown how I made it. I also glued this one with thickened epoxy, thickened with cotton flocks. And I also sanded down the parts where I glued it. So basically in between the lipo straps. And also the back. And also the front in here, over here. And I will add some glass weave from the lipo tray to the bottom of the hull. Probably two layers of 80 grams or maybe 110 grams with a 45 degree rotated weave to make a really strong bond, because I want to prevent this lipo tray coming loose from the bottom. So soon I will start with the servo mount. Probably I will make it from carbon fiber or from wood. I'm not sure. Let's see what kind of idea I will come up with. But overall the boat comes pretty close to the maiden run. Installing the speed controllers, servo, receiver. I also have to decide on where to put the GPS. I think I will strap it just below the hatch, maybe in this position. So when I take the hatch, as it is laminated with carbon fiber, I have to make a cut because the GPS signal will not travel through carbon fiber. So probably I will make a cut here and put a piece of wood or glass weave. I've even been thinking on making a transparent cover from plexiglass or something, so I can read out the speed from the GPS. I'm very excited to see how this boat will run. I plan to run it carefully, but when the boat handles well, of course I want to speed run it and get a new speed record out of it. I hope for a lot of interesting content to come, but that's for another video. So that's it for today. I hope to see you next time and see you later. Bye!